So Adobe updated Premiere Pro in their beta, and they have some cool new features that I wanted to show you guys. I'm gonna show you guys a couple of them. I'm gonna try them out so you guys can see them in action. But then also, if you guys want, you can feel free to follow along. If you have the Creative Cloud, you can go ahead and download Premiere Pro beta and you can try these out yourself. The first thing I wanna talk about are their interactive fade handles. So for the interactive fade handles, here's how this works. Right now on my timeline, I already have two clips and I already made a cut in the middle of them, right? Now, if you notice, if I zoom in here and put my mouse, there's a little gray cube with that little black corner colored in. So this indicates that this is an audio handle that I can interact with. So I'm gonna go ahead and left click it and I can drag this to the left. And then, because we know that what I'm doing is I'm creating an audio transition from the clip on the right into the clip on the left. Now here's the cool thing. If I go ahead and go down, look at that, that cross, the cosine value goes down. If I go up, it goes up. This is really nice as a nice way to ease into other tracks, whether this is for like music, sound effects, or even just audio from one track to another. Or if you wanna get extra spicy, you can right click, go to apply default transitions. And then from here, you can do the same cosine value up and down on both sides. This is just so cool. And I personally really love the visual update this has because I am such a visual guy when it comes to editing. So this is just amazing. Next up, we have their enhanced speech. Now here's the thing with enhanced speech. I'm personally really excited to try it on this specific footage that I have because this whole video, I believe it or not, if you guys watch it, I'll leave it down, or I will probably put a card somewhere on top of the screen, or the video will be linked in the description. But this whole video, I actually edited it and uploaded it using only my iPhone's audio. It was supposed to be a backup audio, but it ended up having to become my main audio. And I think it sounded good overall, but the fact that now it has this AI-powered enhanced speech feature, I really want to see the difference. So let's go ahead and just listen to a portion. Hold on. I actually forgot to record the audio from the screen recording that I did, so you guys can't hear it. But throughout this little section that I recorded again, you are able to hear the enhanced speech being turned on and off. So that way you can see what it sounds like before I have it on, and then you'll see what it sounds like once I have it on. So hopefully this helps kind of determine how the enhanced speech can help the audio. And then also remember, I use it throughout this entire video. Next, let's go over their AI-powered audio tagging and badges. All right, now for AI-powered audio tagging and badges, here's how this one works. If you guys go right here to the audio that I was just using, if you notice that there's these two badges right here, you have the FX badge, which is also a nice new touch, but then you also have this one. Now, this one specifically says that this is dialogue, and that's part of the update. AI can now detect whether the audio that was put is either dialogue, or if it's a music sound, or if it's an SFX. So the cool thing is, because it knows that this is dialogue, if I just click it, it's gonna immediately open the essential sound panel on the right side, and it's gonna give you stuff for specifically dialogue that could help make it better. And the same would be true if you put SFX. So now let me put a sound effect right here on my timeline, which I have ready right here. And then right here, you can see that this one looks different. And this one looks like it has a bang. So that indicates that it's a sound effect badge. So if I click it, now it gives me something or some settings for specifically sound effects. This is really cool. It actually makes it a lot easier to know what you should be messing with for what sounds you have. So like if you just didn't know what should I do with my sound effects to make them sound better, Adobe made it so it just opens up right away. So that is also really good. I love to see it. Now, some other things that they updated that I didn't give a title card for is, for example, like if I put a drop shadow or just some kind of visual effect on my A-roll here, like a drop shadow, you can't see it, but it's there, right? Right here, they have a new button, this FX button. So, and it even shows you, once you hover over it, what's already in that A-roll. So in case you wanna quickly glance in it, you can do that. Or as always, you just click the clip and then it's right here on the top left. But that does look nice, I like that. And the last thing they did, which you probably noticed if you are kind of like a pro Adobe user, is that this color looks different, and that's because they updated the colors. So if I go to label and let's try rose, rose has this, ooh, it has like a more saturated look to it. Purple looks really good, actually. That's, look at that. That looks really nice. Let's try one more. Let's do, what's another one I use all the time? I do use mango a lot. Yeah, and that looks great as well. So nonetheless, a lot of nice new features and a lot of new tools at our disposal in this beta, and I can't wait to see this in the actual public release for everyone to use. And now that you've seen everything that's been updated, as already mentioned, if you have the Creative Cloud, feel free to download the Premiere Pro beta so you can try these out yourself. I actually used all of these new features in this video that you're watching, even the enhanced speech. I am recording on my iPhone 15 Pro Max for this video, so hopefully it sounds good. And if it does, it's probably because of the enhanced speech, because I'm talking towards a kitchen, so it's pretty echoey. But thanks for watching this video. If you guys have any questions, feel free to leave it down in the comment section. And if you guys want to see more of these in the future, I don't mind touching on new stuff. It's more just, I gotta make sure I use it before I talk about it. But give this video a like so I know you liked it. Feel free to subscribe if you're new. I have a lot of new video ideas coming out, and some of those are coming out fairly soon already, so stay tuned for those. But thanks for watching regardless. Have a good rest of your day.